You know, about 20 months ago, the chancellor, and at that time I was the executive vice chancellor, and I made a non-traditional journey into something where we decided we would establish an office of social impact and innovation, which is unusual for many universities because it doesn't quite, the vision that we had for this office didn't quite fit into the curriculum for either teaching or research. And yet we went down this path. Now the fact that UC San Diego or the leadership at UC San Diego took this non-traditional path, it should not be a surprise to most of you because, as many of you know, we take pride in breaking the mold and doing innovative new things. But I want to give you a little bit of a sense of why. The Chancellor touched upon this, but I want to bring out two additional points. The first was that, you know, we had just done a strategic plan, and one of the things that really stood out in the strategic plan as one of the four pillars that we wanted to focus on was to understand the causes of social inequities that are so pervasive in our society, and to try and address those the suffering that is caused by these social inequalities. And so this was part of our strategic plan, and the issue was how could we try and implement this. And a bigger reason for this is that more that this campus, you know, has been rated number one in the nation for seven or more years by the Washington Monthly. And one of the things it is rated number one for is the fact that our students really participate in community service. More than 53% of our students do community service. And of course, all of them want to have the greatest impact in the community service that they provide. And so we wanted to provide them with opportunities for experiential learning. So the primary reason I chose to invest in this effort of creating an Office of Social Impact and Innovation was to combine and align these two. One, the need expressed on behalf of the students to do something impactful with their lives and to use that as part of the education and the ambassador role that they play on behalf of the university. And of course, the strategic goal that had been outlined by our students, faculty, and staff to say, you know, we want to solve these social inequities that exist in the world. So this is what led to the creation of this office. And just at that time, we were very fortunate that Naila Chowdhury, who had spent two decades of her own life trying to deal with the work on empowerment issues, particularly using the cell phone as a conduit, ended up accepting this job. And so that's how social impact and innovation was born here at UC San Diego. So I'd like to take a few minutes just to tell you what is it that has been accomplished and what more do we have to do as we move forward. All right, so first of all, you know, we were able through this office with run almost single-handedly by Naila, one individual, and that I want to bring that out partly to give credit to Naila, but also that each individual can make a tremendous change. We used this to walk out of our ivory tower in the university into the community, and she built deep engagements, and these engagements led to the several global summits, one on women and children empowerment, and two on human trafficking, as well as awareness programs. And with this, then we've decided we'd focus on a variety of social inequities, and there were four that we've really focused on until now. Two you've heard about: women and children empowerment, human trafficking. The third one, which actually I was shocked by on this campus, is that many of our students, undergraduates, graduate students, and even staff, there's a hunger problem. They don't have enough resources to get a good meal on a daily basis. So we've created a food pantry, which, you know, and this office has helped that particular cause. And finally, dealing also with other social inequities. So this is a big mandate for this office, and this example of what you're seeing today in human trafficking is just one example of those. Now, in doing this, the community partnerships that were built extend into the corporate world, into for-profit companies, nonprofit organizations, civic groups, the FBI, Homeland Security, City Council, and the list can go on and on. And I'd like each one of us to take the commitment that we can make today as we walk out to say, bring in other entities so that this becomes, in addition to being the finest city, the finest place where we can solve problems like this in the world. So this is a commitment that's fairly easy for us to make, being part of San Diego. Extending this now, of course, the ambassadors who can accomplish this and we can use this as part of our educational mission is the students themselves. Now, we have close to 32,000 students, and they are the ambassadors who can go about and bring the change. So we've empowered them in a variety of ways. So first of all, you know, through these awareness programs, we've made them aware, and you won't believe the level of interest and enthusiasm that they have to just come into NYLA's office or partner with other groups on campus to get engaged in this. We've also provided, through the Alliance for Empowerment, which NYLA founded, scholarships to these students to really encourage the best students who go out and do community service that is exceptional and inspirational for other people. We've also had these students engage and use their talents to do the kind of programs that you will see now, the theatrical production of increasing awareness in human trafficking. So students are very much a part of this whole exercise and experience and experiment in taking this message out to the world and really using this as an example for the greater problems that they're likely to solve in the rest of their lives as they graduate from UC San Diego and get out into the world. And then this has been really supported in a tremendous way by the faculty, staff, and students on the campus. And they've provided their voluntary support unstintingly. And unlikely groups on campus have really come together in an amazing partnership. And this is an ever-growing partnership. I see this as throwing a stone in a pond and then ripples going out and reaching another one. By word of mouth, not by advertising actively, more and more people have become involved. And this includes people in the Rady School of Management, the Center for Gender Equity and Health, you've heard about these two, but the Qualcomm Institute, this place here in the School of Engineering has become involved. Other departments on campus like theater and dance and other faculty have become involved. And the health sciences, the doctors want to provide solutions to the trafficking victims. So it's really a community that has come together with a cause. And I have not yet heard a single individual, when you have a conversation with them, say, no, I'm too busy, I want to go do something else. Everyone wants to participate in this. And that's the power of choosing a problem that really requires attention, and the entire community is coming together. So let me just end with the following thought. I don't want to bask in the glory of what has been accomplished. This is just the start of a journey that I think will take us far and wide. And the important thing that I'd like to tell you is that let's stop this trafficking of sentient human beings and traffic instead love, compassion, and empathy. And through the power of collaboration, I think we can be an example for the world and really help the trafficking victims and improve their lives. Thank you so much for being here.